Howdy, YouTube. I'm Kyle Ferguson from Into the Nexus podcast, and today we're going to talk about basic positioning. Now, don't walk away. This is important for all types, quick match, ranked included. In general, if you're solo queuing and you are not with your team on comms, how do you know where to be? Well, there's some pretty simple rules I'm going to teach you today. Now, in order to facilitate this complicated conversation on positioning, I've created a doodle zone out of the Cursed Hollow top objective. And we're going to be thinking about Vala as our primary example. There she is, in all her squishy glory. Now, as you approach the objective, many of you probably know not to invade the enemy side. If we're here on the blue team side, heading from this direction, coming up around here, and coming through our gate here, is all decently safe. Of course, this would be our best approach. This would probably be second, and then this third takes us through a little bit of danger down here. If we have control of the enemy side, that means we open up our avenues of approach. So let's imagine instead that our minion waves have pushed out the lane and are currently wailing on this tower up here. Maybe that tower is even destroyed. Suddenly we create a new avenue of approach to the objective, maybe one that will surprise our enemies. These approaches can also change based on our allies. For example, let's say Leoric is doing a bit of anchoring, basically saying that he is standing in this bush, watching out for trouble, and is providing sight in this lower area. Well, now we might have the opportunity to come at the objective from the bottom right. Based on where our sight is, our control of the map, these avenues of approach can change and give us good tactics into the upcoming fight. It might also be worth noting that if the entire enemy team is dead, all of these are on the table. There's no reason to be scared of going anywhere if everybody's dead on the enemy side. I see a lot of people hearthing and being quite scared in the lower leagues when there's no enemies to actually endanger them, no matter how low their health might be. Naturally, positioning opportunities change based on the enemy side and your own allies and what they are providing for you. Let's take, for example, Lili here, who wants to take the Cursed Hollow objective. Isn't that lovely of her? Now, a lot of our Heroes of the Storm players come from World of Warcraft, where this kind of approach might be more in style. The healers are used to staying in the back and being healed bots, whereas the aggressive assassins are up front, taking a little bit of splash damage, but the tank is tanking. This is actually reverse of what you would want in this particular situation. Lili's cups target herself, first and foremost, if she's the only one in range. Lili also has fast feet as a trait, which means if she takes damage, she's actually gaining benefits. Vala cannot really afford to take any damage, and so we would flip this, with Lili being the tank for the moment here, and Vala being in the back. There is always a tank, no matter if you are in a quick match without an official warrior class, or you don't have a melee with CC, there is a tank on your team. It is the character with any regen at all, maybe some CC, but at least a decent amount of health. And in this case, Lili would take up the tanking role. Now, as we start to imagine that, Lili being tank for our Vala here, her positioning becomes very important to where we're able to go. Right now, in her chosen spot, our position is a little restricted. We can come from the top here. This is currently unsafe. There could be a gank coming this way. Lili has gone too far out to allow us to use this avenue as an entrance. So we would be playing in this upper area here, allowing Lili to absorb the incoming damage from the enemy side. If Lili were to change her position of approach, that means we have different angles of approach for our Vala. In this position now, we have free reign of this back left, for the most part, though our bush here is compromised. We may not be able to go in that bush safely. There could be an Uther or an ETC awaiting us with damage to follow. With this sort of example, you can make all sorts of diagrams. Of course, Lili has no damage with her, so if Vala is pushing out the top lane, maybe creating some sort of approach that she might be able to use through the back to create a gank on an enemy Ana, Lili must acknowledge she has no damage with what she's doing, and therefore very little pressure as she battles over the objective. Let's make this team a little prettier. We got our Lili, we got our Vala, and let's add in a proper tank. Maybe a little lucky for our quick match scenario. Now with ETC choosing to join the objective for Cursed Hollow, we have what's known as a core comp. We have a tank, a DPS, and a healer. This three-man can get everything done that needs to be done. The other two might be elsewhere. That's not really our concern. We can beat other groups of three since we have all of our bases covered and enough damage to actually complete a kill. With our previous example, we were thinking about straight lines. If Lili didn't exist here, we would have the same exact thing going on as previous. We would still be limited by ETC's positioning. With Lili on the field here, Lili may feel compelled to become a backline World of Warcraft healer again, and hover in this area. However, that still causes a weakness for Vala here, who can still no longer use this bottom area, and is exposed even from the top, as there is an opening here. What we want to do is get Lili taking one of these avenues, and as Vala, we are thinking with triangles in mind. In this current position, our safest spot for Vala is up here. That is because ETC is manning the front, Lili sorta covers this bottom, and together we make a triangle with us at the point in the back where we're safest. If we were to make the situation more ideal, because Lili can take a couple hits, we can put her here. Now Vala has reign of all this area to position, to vault, to get aggressive, to maybe use that vault in an aggressive way, such as getting a reset on their Hungering Arrow, or making sure they complete that auto attack that is empowered after a vault. What we're asking in this triangle scenario is for our ETC and our Lili to acknowledge that they are less squishy and less vulnerable than Vala, and create an opportunity for her to position more aggressive and wail on that enemy team. If the enemy was in full view here, well then we can tighten this triangle and allow Vala to get that much deeper, and the back of our triangle remains the same, the safest position for Vala here. But we're no longer concerned, because we saw the enemy team, about this bottom avenue of approach. Now to quick matchify this conversation, these shapes, these safety triangles, do not change when you don't have a proper tank or healer. Getting rid of ETC and Lili and replacing them with Kael'thas and Nazeebo still serves the same purpose. Nazeebo here has more health than his allies. Kael'thas here has a stun and is able to at least intercept an incoming player. And we still remain at the back of this triangle as Vala, because we're still the most vulnerable player here. This is asking characters like Nazeebo, like Asmodan, to step up and fill a tank role. That's about acknowledging yourself as the most resilient character on the team, so your Vala can actually get in range to do something. But in those quick match scenarios, you're not only looking at who is most resilient, but who is favored by the enemy team to die the fastest. If there is, for instance, a poorly played Malfiel hanging out on the field, who has died several times already, the enemy team is likely to target Malfiel until he's dead, which means you have free reign to do as much as you want as Vala. Until Malfiel's health reaches zero, the enemy team is so focused on that idea of killing the sweet Malfiel again that they're not going to target your Vala, and you could make an informed aggression choice to be more aggressive, position more aggressive, because you know that team loves killing Malfiel so much. It may also be the case that your team is over-aggressive, and you need to break your triangle usage because they're not going to help you out in the least. Let's imagine this enemy Kael'thas comes walking around the corner. These two dive characters may get so excited about seeing an enemy Kael'thas that they immediately get on his business. What was a nice safe triangle for us in the back has now exposed us to every avenue of gank possible. In order to make this new dive comp work, Vala would have to advance herself. With this new swarmed Kael'thas, we would have to create a new triangle, and we never want that point to be too far out. If we look at it now, our point is about there for safety, to actually have a response from our ally Diablo and Malfiel. These situations are always shifting, but that's what the idea of informed aggression is about, being more aggressive based on information around you. So let's again give ourselves that nice little team comp. We got the Lili, guarding the avenue of attack from the bottom. We have ETC, ready in front of us for a power slide or to fall back if a big attack comes through that bottom aggression spot. But here comes an enemy Butcher, who doesn't particularly care about those various positioning opportunities. Lili, because he's unstoppable, might miss her blind. ETC, because Butcher's unstoppable on engage, might miss his power slide. And with Lamb for the slaughter and a team behind him, he might not care the least and get on top of our squishy Vala. Our proper positioning in this situation is still to use our triangle to make sure that we are positioned safely in the back, but still in range to take advantage of anything that ETC or Lili might set up. However, because of the Butcher's burst in this situation, and we'll go ahead and imagine he's stacked, we would want to be that much safer. And now we're going to hide in a bush, but we can still take advantage of proper positioning and be in range of something that is created by our allies. In fact, we could even be more aggressive here. And we could inform that by saying, well, this top lane is pushed out, so I know that an enemy will not come around through the top of this bush. Otherwise, we'd use this back bush. Simple stuff, but your brain needs to constantly be thinking about where everyone is on the battlefield and how you can take advantage of it. Now look how this situation has changed when we replace our support with someone a little less durable, like Malfurion. We may, due to the enemy style, change up and put ourselves in a more aggressive spot now. Now we're evolving our team positioning to actually account for the health pools and playstyles we have. Even better if we have someone on the field who can take up that role. Now look at us, nice and cozy in between our team, always in response range. If Malfiel likes to fart off, likes to dive the back lane, and not really help out our Vala with a body block or try to kill her target, well then we may have to take up that position again, or Malfurion might have to be a little brave and take that up himself. Let's change up this situation again, but imagine we have a really beefy front line. Our positioning is going to be so strong because of this beefy, CC-heavy front line that we can be really close to our front tanks here. And Vala should be, because Arthas plus ETC is going to make a rather lower damage team than one that might be benefiting from a true bruiser in that Arthas role. We need to be ready to respond to anything they cook up, because if they lock onto a target, it's going to be rather low damage without your participation, so we are that much closer. Let's imagine now in this situation that we are attacked from the back, our very vulnerable spot. Well, we have a clear answer using the triangle method. We would want to continue our triangle, but now on the other side. That's right, we would do an invade of the enemy side because we are still maintaining that strong position and we're actually safer behind our tanks. This is what players often mean when they say, don't run away from your tank. So with this video, this short demonstration, we've gone over a lot of key concepts to being an effective and thinking Heroes of the Storm player. There is always a tank. Acknowledge who on your team has CC, regen, or at least a decent health pool in the quick match environment in particular to be forward and take up that front line. Someone needs to reveal the enemy. It better be a person who can survive the oncoming encounter. Acknowledge core comps. If you have a tank, DPS, and healer, that three-man is capable of killing anybody. If you do not have one of those roles, you are playing much safer. You are playing with informed aggression. Informed aggression is observations you're making about the enemy's side, positioning, makeup, current game state, so you can be more aggressive than your enemy and eke out that win. Those amazing sweet plays that are only capable because you acknowledge you were in a better position. Play with triangles. Don't only find one tank, find two for yourself, and position at the point behind them that is safest. The more CC they provide, the closer up you can be. Your safest spot is not always on your half of the map. And finally, acknowledge your team's play style. If someone is dying nonstop, they will always be targeted at the start of a fight. Keep fighting hard until their health pool reaches zero. If someone is playing great, well, they may be looking for another target, and that target might be you. You might have to hide in a bush for a little bit during the opening of an engage, just to make sure you're not blown up on the spot. Of course, these concepts go much deeper. They are not exclusive to this one part of Cursed Hollow, and every positioning opportunity is going to be different on a different map in a different area. Be thinking critically during your games, even those quick matches. It's how you're going to get a win out of an otherwise silly situation. And thank you to Heroes Hearth for having me. I was Kyle Ferguson. I will see you next week with a new Learn to Play video. Don't forget, like, subscribe, ring that bell here at Heroes Hearth. I'll see you later.